5, a simple doc, part 3 that we created in the previous video, and we're still in the slide sorter view. Before we move on, I want to say a few things about slide sorter view. One of them is why we call it slide sorter view, and that's because it's very easy to reorder or sort our slides in this view. If I want to move slide 4 into the second position, I will click and drag, and releasing it puts it in the second position. I can also click on a slide and hold down shift or control to select multiple slides, just like we can in the slide pane. And I'll move these back. To insert a new slide, I will right click in between the two slides where I want to add my new slide and select new slide. I cannot add text from this view, but if I double click, it takes me to the normal view. It takes a moment here for the slide pane to return, but I can click into the title, add in our title, add in some text, and when I'm ready, I would click on slide sorter to get back to that view. We'll notice that there's no zoom in the lower right-hand corner, but I can control the number of slides per line up here in the slide view toolbar. I'll change this to 3 and 2, and our slides get a little bigger. Increasing the number, we'll make this 5 slides, and I can go larger than the number of slides I have, and it shrinks down our slides a little more. I'll change this back to 5. We've got our 4th slide selected. If I click over here, we've got rehearse timings. Clicking that starts us on the first slide and we can rehearse the timings. Pressing escape to cancel out. We also have hide slide and show slide on this toolbar. And over on our standard toolbar, we've got start from first slide and start from current slide. I'm going back over to the normal tab to continue on from where we left off in the last video, going into slideshow, and we wanted to look at slideshow settings. At the top of the slideshow dialog box, we have something called range. Right now it's set at custom slideshow because that's what we used in the previous video. From here, we could choose either of our 2 custom slideshows. If I select all slides, that would be all the slides in our slide pane that are not hidden. From allows us to select the slide to start from. You saw it was on 4, which is what we have selected. I can change this to 2, and it will start from the second slide. Down below the range, we have something called type. Default is what we're set at. I'm going to change the range to all slides and start the default, and that is the way that the slideshow appears. That's going to be what we already saw, where it takes up the full screen. If we choose window, when I click OK and go into slideshow, it will start our slideshow inside the LibreOffice Impress window. I can go to the next slide and back. So it's actually running our slideshow, but we're inside LibreOffice Impress. Here we can change the window size. We might want to have some other windows open as well. Clicking escape to cancel out. This will also work with rehearse timings. We can rehearse the timings inside of a window. Going back into slideshow settings. Down here, this last one, auto. We will look at this one after we talk about automated slideshows. This is basically the amount of break time you want after a slideshow ends before starting a new slideshow. Next to the type group, we've got options. Starting with change slides manually. We will look at this one later as well. Basically, this turns off any timed slides. Mouse pointer visible. Since I started this tutorial, my mouse pointer has always been visible, so I don't think this does much right here at all. Mouse pointer as a pen. This one is really handy. Checking this, allows us to write on our slides with our mouse during the presentation. I'll check this checkbox and start a presentation. Let's go back into the default view too. Clicking OK. Slideshow. Start from first slide. And we see our mouse has become a little pen. To write on it, I will left click, and this allows me to write anything I like. When I release the left click, it does not write. If I right click on this presentation, we have a context menu. And one of the things we see here is mouse pointer as a pen. So we can get to it from here as well. If in the middle of the presentation we decide, oh, we need to write on the slide, we would right click and choose mouse pointer as a pen. We can also change the pen width. We have it at normal. We can make it very thin or very thick. I'll make it very thick. Right clicking again to bring up the context menu. I'm going to change the pen color. If we know what color we want, we can type in the RGB numbers, the HSB, or the CMYK. Or I can just pick a color that I like from this rainbow here. I'm going to make this blue. And then we see this white circle here. If I move it to the left, it becomes more white. This is the previous color. This is the proposed color. And when I click OK, it will become the color. And I am going to make this a nice dark blue. Clicking OK. And now we have a thick, dark blue line that we're using. Right clicking, I can erase all the ink on the slide. Also in this context menu, we've got the screen. We can make it black. Or we can make it white. And we can also change it from black to white, or white to black. And then clicking black again turns it off. Also in this context menu, we can go to the next slide. We can go to a specific slide if we know the slide number. And we can end the slideshow. Same thing as pressing escape. And going back into slideshow, slideshow settings. We did not need to be in the default view to use the pointer as a pen. And we did not even have to have that turned on. Checking that off, using window. Start from first slide. Right clicking, mouse pointer as pen. And we see it works here inside the window as well. I will erase all the ink on the slide and cancel out. Going back into slideshow, slideshow settings, navigator visible. Turning that on makes our navigator visible. We see that the navigator is also here on the bottom. This gives us our choice of slides. When I go into the slideshow, start from first slide, here's our navigator, same thing as we have over here. And this might be handy if you wanted to jump around, and I'm double clicking to quickly jump to a specific slide. Slideshow, slideshow settings, animations allowed. We haven't talked about animations yet. And change slides by clicking on background. That might be handy if you only wanted to use the page up, page down, and the arrow up and down to go to the next slide. We notice that presentation always on top is not active here. That will be active if I change the type to default. And most of the time, we would always want our presentation on top. But when we're running our slideshow inside the Impress window, this is not available. And multiple displays, we're going to start here. In the next video, I'm going to cancel out of here and save this as ODP06, a simple doc, part 3. Well, I'm going to take off the part 3 and I will call this ODP06, a simple doc. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.